Okay then, hey guys, what's up? It's me, Priscilla, and we have here my Inktober 2020 sketchbook. So, if you've been following with me this whole entire October, I've been posting like time lapses of every single one of these drawings. Now, the thing about this is that I didn't really explain. I didn't talk too much about the prompts and why I drew stuff, so you're gonna understand that today with the prompts. All right, first off, let's talk about this awesome sketchbook. It's by Viviva Colors, Color Sheets. I used this Viviva Color Sheets, their watercolor sheets, the entire Inktober, and I mean, look how used up it looks now. This has been one of the best portable tools I've ever had. So if you're interested, you can look in the description box down below. I'll give you all that fun stuff to go and get your own, maybe for Christmas. I would not advise, this is how I decorated my sketchbook, I would not advise to decorate this because you can't exactly, once you got it, oh, see, there's some loose stuff back here. Once you can't really fold it because, you know, it's not, I don't know what I was thinking, but you know, they're 3D looking flowers. I wouldn't do that. You can see from the very beginning, I wrote out all of the prompts and I kind of wrote down what I wanted to do, kind of, and here's the swatching from this one only. Viviva actually sent me two different sketchbooks and I actually left one of them in our Hertz rental car and they threw it away along with my Inktober Viviva watercolor color sheets, the actual official Inktober one. So yeah, don't like them, and I was very angry. So you see I got my swatches. So here we go, first page. This is actually what I did, like the example that I was gonna do for like Viviva's like color sheets. I wanted to show how it looked in the sketchbook, and then I decided this is officially what I was gonna do. So I wanted to do, you know, my awesome ballpoint sketching with my regular Bic ballpoint pen, and then do my cross hatching, and then use the watercolor along with sepia Bombay ink. Started with the second day, and it was Wisp. So I've got Merida with a wisp in her hair, super cute. And then the first day of Inktober was fish. So just to kind of try it out, I did do a Ponyo little sketch because I love this movie. I think it's beautiful with all the ocean creatures. And I actually have another fish in here somewhere, but you see I'm gonna keep going. This day was bulky. Day three was bulky. So I've never drawn much Mario Nintendo characters before, so I thought this would be a great opportune moment to draw Bow Wow Wowzer. He's big and bulky and terrifying in every single darn Mario game. I'm a Mario girl. I play Mario like games my whole life. Bowser's a very terrifying villain. Then we've got another fish drawing because I didn't record Ponyo. I was just kind of giving it a try. So here's my official like recording of Dory and Marlin. So this is officially day one because I didn't want to leave anything behind. Oh look, an empty page. This is the only downfall to this sketchbook is that it did not erase well at all. Didn't erase well. And you can see I tried to like, I wanted to draw myself and Shelby in like costumes, but then I was like, no, I gotta save my pages because I went ahead and counted the pages and I wasn't gonna have enough days for Inktober. So I tried to erase it and it just didn't turn out well. So not good for erasing. Today was radio. I was researching like old radio shows and it had me actually thinking of A Christmas Story. You know, You'll Shoot Your Eye Out Kid with the Red Ryder BB gun. A lot of mixed feelings about that movie. However, I was thinking of like, you know, old radio shows. And I remember in A Christmas Story, they ran and there's this whole scene involving little orphan Annie. And Annie's one of my favorite musicals. So I went ahead and drew the little orphan Annie, like the 1982 version. This day is Blade. Now this is a movie that doesn't get enough recognition. It's very underrated. Sword in the Stone. King Arthur pulling the sword out of the stone. I was trying to kind of keep it a little bit old school. So I'm trying to keep it old school within the sketchbook and you'll kind of see. Day six was rodent and I drew my favorite rodent of them all. And I thought I'm gonna start at the very, very beginning. So I drew little Mickey Mouse as Steamboat Willie. Day was one of my favorites, and it was Fancy, because, you know, I'm watching a lot of Amazon Prime stuff, and all of SpongeBob is on Amazon Prime, in case you didn't know that. So I went back to this episode from the beginning, and when I saw the date was Fancy, I was like, Pinky up, SpongeBob! I had to. I could not resist. This day is teeth. What a better smile to draw. One of the days is that I didn't know what to draw for throat, because there was a lot of ideas I had, but at the same time, it's like, I don't want to draw any of these because I'm not feeling really inspired. Instead, I went back to my very first Inktober drawing, and I drew, like, not my first Inktober drawing, but the first year I participated in 2013 in Inktober, I drew little Ariel and a pumpkin and a witch hat and a little itty bitty spider. So I went ahead and I drew this. So that was the whole inspiration. It was like a redraw. It was a lot of fun. I thought that it turned out pretty good compared to 7 years ago. All right, and then we have the day for hope. I always try to make a point to draw something from Narnia every Inktober. So there's a lot of things I like to redraw. This is actually a redraw too. It was like a digital drawing and somebody said, oh, you have the same face syndrome. Well, yeah, I did, but you know, there's a lot of other people that have same face syndrome. It's just something artists have to work through. I went ahead and redrew this scene that I made and it turned out 10 times better. Lucy doesn't look like all the other characters I've ever drawn, and Aslan looks 10 times better too. This is for Hope because if you follow Chronicles of Narnia, you know why. Alright, so this day was actually discussed, and I really hate this drawing. I don't like it. I think it is my least favorite of Inktober 2020. I don't like it. I tried to do my own spin-off of Disgust, and I was like, I don't like it. Ugh. So, yeah, we're gonna not talk about this one. Alright, this day was slippery, and Animal Crossing saved me from insanity, I guess. I drew Pascal. And Pascal was during the summer update for Animal Crossing. If you guys play, then you know. And he was just my favorite. I love him. He's so adorable. I've never said no to him. I always give him all my oysters. And he gives me beautiful mermaid stuff or fun pearls. So this guy was the height of my summer. Otter, slippery, water, you know. That's why I made that connection. I make weird connections with these words. This day was Dunes, and I drew Aladdin going to the Cave of Wonders for the magic lamp because I was trying to think of desert scenes, and I actually thought of the Little Prince when the airplane pilot dude crashes in the desert and he meets the Little Prince. I thought of drawing him, the aviator, my bad. I thought of him drawing that, and then I thought, no, there's gotta be a better desert scene, and I thought, oh my gosh, I could draw a Cave of Wonders with Aladdin. Ah! This day was armor. Drew the Mandalorian. This is the first time I've officially drawn him, and I wanted to do the old armor instead of the new armor that he got in the show, if you watch it. And it's the first time I've drawn him. I definitely want to give it another try because I don't feel like it's proportionate, but you know, I did try. He's got so many gadgets on him and so many divots and so many different discolored things. It's kind of hard to like draw it. He's just a lot of symmetrical things going on. Armor is difficult, and when people draw armor, you guys are skilled because, man, it's difficult. Here's another redraw because I didn't know what to draw for Outpost. All I could think about was the post office. That's all I could think about. And I didn't know what to draw. So I did another redraw from my Inktober 2014 of Belle and the Beast, and it turned out so much better, and I actually drew that original drawing from 2014 Inktober after hearing the Ellie Goulding song, Beat of Your Heart, whatever it's called, Beating Heart, I don't know, it's from that one Divergent movie, I forgot, but it's that song, and that's what it's based off of, just like having her listening to his heart. So that's the whole inspiration behind that. Okay, so for this day, it was Rocket. Once again, I went back to SpongeBob. Remember when Patrick and SpongeBob went to the moon and they thought they were on the moon? Turned out they were in Bikini Bottom the whole time, and they captured everybody and then ended up taking them to the moon. All right, here's another day. This day was Storm. And I really like how this turned out because I was really afraid how am I going to draw them laying on the sand because I wanted to get this image right. The only thing I don't really like is that she looks like she's sick, like she's tired or sick. I darkened around her eye way too much. Storm, I thought, you know, when Prince Eric gets knocked off of his ship and into the water, Ariel saves him and takes him ashore. That's the whole inspiration for that. This one actually turned out to be one of my favorite drawings that I've done for Inktober. One of my favorites. I'll go ahead and give you guys an idea what my favorite drawing is this whole Inktober. In this one, it was for Trap. So the day was, the prompt was Trap, and I thought, you know, Meg sings about being trapped. It's a trap to be in love. I won't say it, no. You know, I won't say I'm in love. And that's why I associated with, because I thought about, it's a trap from Star Wars. And I thought, I don't want to draw that ugly dude. So I'm not going to draw that. So I drew Meg saying, you know, it's a trap to be in love. Or to be in love again, because she was already in love and she learned her lesson. If you haven't seen Hercules, not giving any more spoilers. All right. So this is like one of my other favorite drawings, and this was for Dizzy. But yeah, if you're falling down the rabbit hole, you're probably really dizzy. So that's the connection from that word to this drawing. And I love it because I was challenging myself more to do different positions of like people, like really pushing myself to do different positions of, like, instead of just looking on them front on. So that's what this whole thing is. I wanted to do, like, she's looking behind herself, you're seeing the back of her instead of the front, and she's clearly falling. So I'm really proud of this drawing. I did a good job. In my mind, I did a good job. Okay, this day was Coral, and I love recreating old vintage, like, Simplicity and McCall's sewing pattern designs for those. And I love doing, like, with the Posca pins. If you follow me on Instagram, that's what I did. I used a Posca pin for this Coral drawing, and it turned out wonderful. And this is from a Simplicity pattern. I don't know who the original artist is, but I did use, like, this drawing as an inspiration from that pattern design, the dress and the overall look, gave my own spin to it. So I did like a Dapper Day Finding Nemo dress. So if you want to be Nemo for Dapper Day for Disney, whenever we have another Dapper Day, Lord willing, that's in the future soon, then here is an inspiration for Nemo. This day was Sleep. And the reason why I drew Maleficent is because I originally thought I want to draw Aurora or Snow White sleeping, and I thought I've already done that before. One for Inktober. So I was like, nah, what else can I draw? And I was thinking, what about drawing the evil mistress that casted the spell in the first place to fall asleep? So I went ahead and drew Maleficent. This was a failed drawing because Tiana's arm and her head are all messed up. I wanted to do Chef, and it did not work out right because her arm's really wrong, her body is disproportionate, it's like her torso's not long enough for what's going on here. I mean, her dad turned out great in my opinion, and I was getting ready to finish it, but then I just kept looking at her arm and how disproportionate she was, and I was like, I give up. So I did try. I wanted Tiana to fit in here somewhere, and I did eventually find a day for her to where I wanted Tiana in this whole, like, Inktober. Okay. Instead, I drew our wonderful little chef, Remy, and because I just think he's so cute. This day was Rip. So I've drawn Corpse Bride a couple. No, I've only drawn her once for an Inktober, so I thought I want to draw her again and give it my own kind of take, and it is really shiny. If you look at it in person, the butterflies are shiny and the flowers are shiny on her headdress, on her dress, and in her bouquet, and I really love how this one turned out. And the color sheets really pop. Like, half of it is my shiny blue ink, and then the other half is like Viviva's color sheets. Oh, it's so beautiful. The peacock blue in this watercolor set, it's beautiful, gorgeous. I love using that blue. Okay, so here is where I fit Tiana in. This day was Dig, and I immediately started singing in my head, you gotta dig deeper, find out what you need. I don't know the words. But then I thought of like Tiana when she's like, blue skies and sunshine. You know, that's what I thought of when I wanted to do that scene. So I did get Tiana in here, but she's in frog form. But I love how this came out. I love the colors. I love how the bottles came out. Love how she came out. Came out perfect. It's just what I wanted. All right, another drawing I'm not too fond of is Buddy. I wanted to draw a little Baby Yoda. He's tough. He's tough to draw. If you've ever drawn Baby Yoda, you want to get the cuteness factor in there, but at the same time, you're looking at him and you're drawing him and you're thinking, this guy's kind of wrinkly and ugly. I know, I can't believe I just said that. Overall, he's adorable, but I don't like how I drew him, and I kind of wanted to redo it again, so not a huge fan of Buddy. Then we get to Hyde, and I remember drawing this back a long time ago as a watercolor of Rapunzel and Flynn hiding in the little like hallway crevice with their cupcakes. I thought it was adorable. I still think it's adorable. The only thing I don't like is how I shaded her chin. Kind of gives it a weird look, but in person it doesn't look like that, but somehow on camera, like I'm looking at the viewfinder now and on my phone, it just looks weird, and I might try to fix that later on before I sell it. So this actually concludes my whole sketchbook. However, I did move on and finish everything out on watercolor paper. Next day was music, and I drew. I was a theater major in college, and I got my bachelor's in theater. So I drew my love that gave me the theater bug, which is the Phantom of the Opera. And that this overall musical is what bit me and got me into theater, so I thought I'd give him a little contribution. Love how this turned out. Looks like the old silent film, but I looked at the still of when he is asking for her hand through the mirror during Angel of Music. And when I drew this, I love how the ink blotted out on the watercolor paper. And I wanted a little bit of color in there, so I threw in the roses, because if you know the musical, you know the significance of red roses. So that's what was going on. And I used Posca pens to make everything, like my white Posca pen to pop everything, and it really helped. For flow, I was thinking of Ghost. I naturally thought of Constance. Constance is one of my favorite ghosts from Haunted Mansion. Other than the Hatbox Ghost, which is another huge favorite of mine, I was either gonna draw him, the hitchhiking ghost, or Constance. And I thought, well, geez, it's been a while since I've drawn Constance, and I always try to make a point to draw a Haunted Mansion kind of character. And I love how this turned out. And if you've seen the time-lapse, you saw how the drips came down. Ugh, this is beautiful. I love how this turned out. I'm really proud of this. It just looks right. It looks eerie, and I love it. And I just love how the only thing that's not shaded in, other than a little bit of heavy lining, is the axe. So I love this one. This is great. Hatchet, whatever. Okay. The next day was shoot. Of course, everybody, if you know this timeless children's tale, you know Dorothy and her ruby slippers. Fun story, I actually didn't draw Toto. I drew Rosie, my puppy dog, my parents' puppy dog, because she's just this little fat thing, and I just thought she'd be a cute Toto. So that's what's going on here. I kind of like this. I kind of don't. I don't know. It's different. Once again, I was just trying to do different angles. Like I've been telling you guys, I've been trying to like really push myself this Inktober. So that's what's going on here. But I really love how I did like the yellow brick road in the background and the posies and the greenery. I do like how I did that. I think those turned out great. But yeah, shoes. I draw the Sanderson sisters every day, every Inktober, just because I like to see how much I've improved, and I have really improved if you look at them. And Crawl, I didn't know what to do for Crawl. I still don't know, and I don't think I'll get to it. I actually drew this for because I went to Disney World for my birthday. I took a picture of this next to the wishing well where I got proposed to. That's it, guys. That's Inktober 2020. And if you haven't heard already, I am selling a ton of these in my Etsy store. I'm a freelance artist willing to take commissions or to sell these pretty cheap. I was thinking like $15 a drawing. And yep, This was a good year. This is one of my best Inktobers I've done, and I said that I would pick a favorite, and I honestly think my favorite out of all these drawings, I think my favorite is gonna be a tie in between these two, because I just love how awesome they turned out, and that I really love the peacock blue from the color sheets. So this turned out beautiful. And then I love how this whole stance turned out. So I gotta say it's between these two that are my favorites of Inktober 2020. Thank you guys so much if you've been keeping up with my videos throughout the month. Thank you for watching. I'm also really proud of the Sanderson sister things. But yeah, this was a great sketchbook. These are wonderful. If you want a Christmas gift and you don't want to ask for, these are wonderful. But yes guys, thank you so much. Bye!